This time on Inside Opera, we're going outside to speak with superstar bass baritone Luca Pizzaroni about his role as Maometto II for the COC. So we're here at Toronto's Trinity Bellwoods Park to catch up with him and his two constant companions, his dogs, Lenny and Tristan. Why is this repertoire, the opera seria, not performed so frequently?
I think most of the time we have an idea of what the Rossini should sound like or what it's going to be. And this piece, actually, it's completely different and it makes change your mind about what the Rossini seria is. And I love this piece because I saw it the first time, it was 1994, La Scala with Sam Raimi. And I remember at the time looking down when he came out to sing his first aria and I said, to myself, I hope one day I get to sing it. So when they asked me if I wanted to do it, I immediately said yes, before actually looking at the score. And then when I said yes, and I looked at the score, I thought, oh God, I can't do it. Right. I should never have said yes.
Momentous difficulties notwithstanding, you've made this a bit of a signature role for yourself. Like, nobody really sings Maometto.
No, it's not.
You're the Maometto guy. Yeah, you're basically, I mean, Luca Maometto II Pizzaroni. This is your middle name.
Oh, I like that.
First time in Toronto?
First time in Toronto.
And you're in practice?
At the opera, actually.
At the opera.
I sang a recital at the Roy Thomson Hall.
Oh, right.
And
okay.
With Michael Schaden.
Let me ask about the origins in the names. Tristan Isom has
Tristan
some
opera. And he barks all the time, so we said he's definitely a tenor. And
Lenny, because of Lenny Bernstein. They are with me all the time, they travel with me. And they're having actually a very good time here in Toronto.
Yeah, how are they with travel? Like, because you spend most of your time traveling.
Yes.
When you're not traveling, where do you live?
I live in Vienna. We travel, I would say, 10 months a year.
That's a lot.
And that's a lot, and they love it, actually. They are used to it, and for them, it's absolutely is what normal is for them. Last year, I spent 23 days at home.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
How do you keep yourself sane?
That's a good question. It's not that easy, and I don't think I'm that sane. I try to make home everywhere where I go. I'm in Toronto here, and my wife is with me, my dogs are with me, so for me, this is home.
Do they speak Italian? Like, do you speak Italian to them or in English?
We speak English and German to them, actually. And German when I'm upset.
Sometimes people think that Rossini is going to be something that is very static, people are not moving that much. It's not enough. You have to make believable characters. And David Alden is wonderful in digging into the roles and try to find a psychological reason why you have to do things on stage. And Harry is a phenomenal conductor. Harry is one of my favorites, and because he remembers the tempi. There is a tempo that is too slow and a tempo that is too fast. And then there is the right tempo. And Harry always gets the right tempo,
which
is perfect. For me, the story and the piece is so complex. I am portrayed as the evil role and the evil character, when in fact, I'm not sure I am so evil at the end of the story.
So he's the only honest one. Everybody else succumbs to a kind of equivocation.
In a way, I think he's the only one honest. He's the only one that you know if he says one thing, he means it. And the thing to me is that at the end, people realize that life is not about black and white. I think the audience will think about it and will look at people with a little bit more of understanding than just be so judgmental every time.
Catch Luca Pizzaroni as Maometto II at the Four Seasons Center for the Performing Arts from April 29th to May 14th. Visit coc.ca for tickets right now.